Hi, I'm Vance Vredenburg, and I'm going to show you how to collect a skin swab from a live amphibian. Now, these skin swabs are used to measure the presence of a fungal pathogen that infects amphibians called Batrachochytrium dendrobatidis, and it causes a pathogen, it causes a disease called chytridiomycosis. So what you need to collect these data are a actual skin swab, a vial to go with it, a pair of gloves. All right, we're ready to go. Our test subject today is the Wyoming toad. Here's this little guy right here. These are really cool toads. They live in, guess where, Wyoming. And they are extinct in the wild and alive in captivity. So this technique doesn't take very long, and it also is not meant in any way to harm the animal, okay? And it doesn't if you do it right. Flip the guy over. So chytrid infections, BD infections, tend to happen on the lower side of the animals, on the ventral side. And what I'm going to do is take 30 strokes on this animal, and I want to cover a couple of different important areas. You can see right here, see the drink patch area right here? So this is an area in toads that is often moist, which is an area that BD is likely to be infecting an animal in, even at very low levels of infection. I'm also going to cover much of the ventral side, including the legs and the digits as well. Okay, so I'm going to do 30 strokes. So the way I do it is I split it up into fives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 10. And I'm going to do 5 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now I've done 15 on one side. Now I'm going to switch to the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I don't want to hurt the guy. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now notice the swab, the synthetic cotton is kind of coming off of there. That's good. Also notice the animal is not distressed. Okay, so you do it hard enough to get some friction on there because you're breaking little skin cells off, but you don't do it so hard that you hurt the animal or stress out the animal. So now he is perfectly fine. I'm gonna set him back down in his cage. And now what I do is I get a little microcentrifuge tube, 1.5 mils, open it up. You want to get the kind that when you heat it up, it doesn't pop open, so you want either a snap lid with a hook or a twisting lid like this one. I break it off, put it inside, put the lid on, and now I am finished. There is my chytrid swab. We will then extract DNA from this for the qPCR assay. All right, I'm going to collect a chytrid swab from this frog right here. This is Hyliola regilla, the Pacific chorus frog or Pacific tree frog. It's very common here in California and is one of the species that is mostly resistant to the chytrid fungus, which has been devastating to amphibians around the world. This guy has a pit tag, which is a microchip. It's right in front of my thumb right there. It's about the size of a grain of rice. It's a way that we can individually identify amphibians, and it's typically used not only in lab studies but in field studies as well. I'm going to turn them upside down because the chytrid tends to be more often found on the moist side of the amphibians. So now I'm going to take 30 strokes from this guy from the ventral side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that's 20 strokes now, and I covered his belly and his inner thighs, especially in here. I'm also going to take the last 10 strokes I'm going to do on the feet, which tends to be an area where we find chytrid a lot. Doing 5 each. Now these guys are small frogs, so you have to be really gentle. Notice when I hold him upside down, and his legs are straight, so he's not struggling, and he's just sort of sitting there in a very safe position. You want to be really careful with frogs because you can break their legs very easily if you're not careful. And this is a technique that doesn't harm the animal, so we want to do it swiftly, gently, and efficiently. Notice the swab has some of the synthetic cotton coming off the top, which means that it's actually been dragging against this and collecting tissue, so that's a good sign. So you want it to be hard enough where it bends a little bit and you're getting some friction, but not so much that it causes the animal to freak out. I've now broken the tip off of this swab, very careful not to touch anything with it, and I put it into my vial, close it up, and it is ready for extraction. Voila.